يا نبينا بالمدينة، يا نبينا بالمدينة، بليلة وداعك نشوف الدمع سجار، تريد ترحل واحنا نسأل، تريد ترحل واحنا نسأل، قبل ما ترحل نريدك تنطي الجواب، انت رايح.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome to Al Imam Al Hussein TV 3 with this exclusive report. Well, today we are here nearby the holy shrine of Al Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, the Prophet's successor and son-in-law and the Shia's first Imam. And people have came from wide and far towards this holy land to commemorate the martyrdom of the Prophet Muhammad, the Prophet of humanity and the Prophet of peace, who was sent by Allah to uplift people from ignorance to knowledge. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, for further details and for further information about this great and this important event here in the holy city of Najaf, do please stay with us.
يتعنى ويجي عسى يكون يعلم جوابه. بارك الله بيكم.
Welcome again, brothers and sisters. Right now we are in the area adjacent to the holy shrine of Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam, the Prophet's successor and son-in-law and Shia's first Imam. Right now we are joined by one of the visitors who came from Australia. So, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam, brother.
Adham ajurkum inshaAllah. May Allah accept your deeds.
Thank you, brother.
Okay, great. So what's your name?
My name is Sayyid Mudaffar.
So you came from Australia, right?
Yes, I came from Australia.
Great. So can you tell us about your feelings, about your emotions?
It's just overwhelming, you know? So when you come here, it's just, it's hard to explain, brother.
Right.
It's all the spiritual things, you know, it's really hard to explain. I'm really emotional. I came here and I did my ziyarah, and I feel full of energy now.
MashaAllah. So can you tell us a specific reason why did you come to here? What makes you come to here? What's the reason?
So the reason I came here is to visit our Imam, Imam Ali alayhi salam. He's our first Imam. So I came here to visit Imam Ali, and then I'll go down to Karbala after this.
MashaAllah. So what would you like to say to our viewers globally from all over the world? What would you like to tell them? Would you like to invite them to come and visit the holy shrine of Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam?
Definitely. They have to come. If they're the Shia of Imam Ali, they have to come and visit the shrine of Imam Ali. It's totally different. You can't experience this anywhere else. Okay. You have to come and experience it for yourself right here.
MashaAllah. And these days we are witnessing a very important ritual, important event, which it is the martyrdom of the Prophet Muhammad, the Prophet of humanity and the Prophet of the peaceful message. What did you learn from the Prophet Muhammad?
Well, I basically live all my life according to the life of Prophet Muhammad. So he's our role model, you know. He's the one we follow.
MashaAllah. So we can say that the Prophet Muhammad is an inspiration to every single Muslim from all over the world, right?
True, not only the Muslims, to all the humanity.
Great. And we discussed the verse from the Holy Quran which says, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that we've sent you just to be a mercy for all people from all over the world.
That's right, that's right. It's for all the human beings, not just the Muslims. Any human beings, they have to follow the Prophet Muhammad, you know. It's an inspiration for everyone.
MashaAllah. Brothers and sisters, it is the Prophet Muhammad and the message of the Prophet Muhammad. It is an inspiration to every single Muslim globally from all over the world, regardless of your background, regardless of from which country you are. The main reason is that you are a human being, and the Prophet Muhammad has a universal message, and that message of humanity. Brothers and sisters, my brother Sayyid came from Australia. You see, the diversity is very important and very unique here in this great event. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, for more details and further information, do please stay with us.
اسمع انت تنعي وهي تدعي
شنو
علي يا رب اسم الوالد تديمه علي يا رب اسم الوالد تديمه.
Welcome again, respected viewers, brothers and sisters. And at this moment, I am joined right now by one of the clergymen to discuss with him a very important verse from the Holy Quran, where Allah, the Almighty, said, "وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ." That the purpose that we have sent the Prophet Muhammad is just to be the mercy for all people from all over the world. So let's talk with the Shaykh and see what does that mean for us.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين. هناك آيات كثر غير وما أرسلناك إلا رحمة العالمين. هناك وما أرسلناك إلا كافة للناس بشيرا ونذيرا. الرسالة السماوية، الرسالة الإلهية، الرسالة المحمدية هي خاتمة الرسائل السماوية. هناك رسائل، هناك أنبياء، هناك رسل سبقوا الإسلام وسبقوا محمد، ولكن كانت على مستوى حقيقة ضيق، على مستوى الأقوام. لاحظوا إن أرسلنا نوحا إلى قومه أن انذر قومك، ولا عاد أخاهم هودا. ويقول لاحظوا وياي عندما قال عيسى بن مريم، وإذ قال عيسى بن مريم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وإذ قال عيسى بن مريم يا بني إسرائيل إني رسول الله إليكم مصدقا لما بين يدي من التوراة ومبشرا برسول يأتي من بعدي اسمه أحمد. هنا في هذه الحقيقة، في هذا العرض العظيم لهذه الآيات الكريمة المعتبرة، نلاحظ بأن الله سبحانه وتعالى جعل خاتمة الرسائل رسالة القرآن، رسالة السماء، لأن القرآن هو المعجزة الخالدة على عكس المعاجز. كانت المعاجز اللي سبقت الإسلام، معجزة موسى مادية، معجزة عيسى مادية، أرن الله جهرة، أرسل لي مائدة من السماء ومن تلك بيمينك يا موسى. لاحظوا وياي، لاحظوا وياي، كذلك إبراء الأكمه والأبرص وإحياء الموتى، بينما محمد بن عبد الله كان يتحدى قل لئن اجتمعت. لاحظوا وياي، قرآن كلام، ولكن وهنا يكمن الإعجاز. قل لئن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله ولو كان بعضهم لبعض ظهيرة، لأنه كانت رسالة السماء. بعدين تنازل من الناحية التحدي التصعيدي، قال على أن يأتوا بعشر سور، بعدين قال على أن يأتوا بسورة، بعدين قال على أن يأتوا بحديث بمثله. لذلك رسالة محمد بن عبد الله جاءت للبشرية جمعاء، للخير، للعطاء، إلى أن يرث الله الأرض ومن عليها. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, this a clergyman, this scholar said that what about this verse when Allah said in the Holy Quran, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that we only sent you, O Muhammad, just to be a mercy for all people from all over the world. The Prophet Muhammad, first and foremost, and the message of the Prophet Muhammad is that it's a universal message. And the mission of the Prophet Muhammad is just a continuation for all missions and for all the duties that the prophets before the Prophet Muhammad, like the Prophet Noah and the Prophet Abraham and all the prophets before the Prophet Muhammad who came for, which it is just to separate justice, unity, unison, and to eradicate like oppression, segregation, and all factors that will lead to destabilize any society from all over the world. And what makes this special, what makes the Prophet Muhammad special in the eyes of the world, is that the Prophet Muhammad, a lot of people in the world, in the West especially, when they are looking to us as Muslims, they believe that we have a prophet and he's just only for us. No, Allah said, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, that just your message is just for all people from all over the world. Every single person can participate in this great mission of the Prophet Muhammad and can join Islam and can read about the Prophet Muhammad and his progeny. Respected viewers, brothers and sisters, for more information and for more details and for further details about this great event, do please stay with us.
ظلت الزهرة يا ابو ابراهيم تنحب واجت بنتها وساعدتها هذه زينب.